shooting?
Didn't you hear? We're about to find ourselves in the middle of a race war.
I've seen you shoot. I think I'll be aye.
Hey, with this fucking rifle, I'm Wild Bill Hickok. So, how's the Padre handling all this? You know, the bloody path of mayhem and revenge you've embarked upon?
Still not happy about it. Thinks you're most likely the devil.
You know, I had a look at his service record. Oh, settle down. I was just curious. He was a medic, but he saw action at Climbaugh with the 614th. He was credited with taking out 2 Kraut tanks on top of the 16 men he shot. A lot of killing for a would-be priest.
That was different. It was during a war.
And this isn't? Look, I'm just saying, we didn't win that war by worrying about hurting someone's feelings. We won it by bombing the Krauts and Nips back to the Stone Age. Padre'd be wise to remember that.
Yeah, maybe. I'll catch you later.
You're not still sore about me looking into the Padre, are you? I guess you were able to keep Burke sober long enough to get him on our side. I assume Burke gets how this little arrangement works now that he's got Point Verdun back? Sal's the same as those communist fucks we were fighting over in Nam. He's a tick, a lazy fuck who lives off the work of others. Fucking asshole. President Johnson's a goddamn pussy. He started that war, he should stick around to finish it.
I got here is top of the line material. Ain't no better price than all.
Watch where you put your hand.
Just saw from where his daddy would visit, he called along. At the time, I understood the pain Lincoln was in. Come home from war expecting peace. But in Lincoln's case, all he found was pain. Heartbreak. Ain't no way that doesn't drive you down into the muck and mire. Anyways, I was thinking, hoping really that if I could help him find a little closure, maybe we could shift his focus away from the Marcanos. See, he was in a coma when we laid Sammy and Ellis to rest, so he ain't never had a chance to say his goodbyes. Thought maybe if he did, he might see that he had a chance at a normal life. If there ever was a soul more wrong than I, I do not know him. Just going to Sammy's like this is gonna do you a lot of good, Lincoln.
I'll be honest with you, Father. I hardly see the point in it.
The hard thing to let go, to say goodbye.
Saying goodbye won't give me what I want, Father.
Maybe what you want isn't what you need, son. Your Lily called yesterday, checking up on you again. Think she's setting her mind on doing something with Sammy's.
Can't hardly see what. The shape it's in and all.
Well, she's always been a woman of determination. Don't know if you recall, but after Perla passed, Sammy went to a dark place. Buried the loss deep down. Started running girls out the back of the bar at all hours of the night. Finally, Lily had enough. She marched in with the fire of God inside of her, kicked all those girls out, customers, Sammy's crew. And boy, if she didn't lay into her brother like I've never seen. Told him he was doing wrong by Perla. But more importantly, he was doing wrong by you boys. Sending a message that their mother didn't matter. From that point on, there was no more prostitution in that place.
Huh. All I remember from that time is Aunt Lily swooping in and taking us to her place for a few nights. Getting ice cream and such.
She protected you boys. Family like that's a gift from God, son. Out front. You need to get on inside.
Hey, what the hell?
Help me! Oh, God, they come in!
Who is?
Them.
Get back here, Anna.
Stay with her.
Let's go. Come on.
Who the fuck are you? He's right up there!
Fountain blade!
Sweetheart.
Anna.
You're gonna be okay. Lincoln, this here's Anna. And those men.
Dealt with. But if more come, I want y'all out of here.
One of my parishioners, she's out of town, has an apartment in Tickfaw. It's safe.
You don't know that.
I'll take her there. Meet me when you're ready.
All right. Gonna take a look around inside first. Locked.
In blood.
Locked.
Covered in blood.
Jesus. Who the fuck were those people? Should use my recon camera here. Everybody tells a story. Shot him as he was running away. Ligature marks. Must have had him tied up. So they drag him in here. When he tries to escape, they shoot him dead. But why were they in here at all? Covered in blood. That's what that girl Anna was saying. Now what the hell happened to you? Interesting. Signs of being restrained. Some kind of tattoo might mean something. Seen a card like this. Flowers hand painted. Looks like he took a knife to the gut. Looks like you messed with the wrong girl. Burning. Some kind of incense or something. This thing looks ritualistic. These markings. Strangest thing. Think I have what I need. Should go meet with Father James.
During World War II, they called it battle fatigue. Maybe even combat stress reaction. But I think the term that I always preferred was shell shock. We all heard it said before that war is hell. Ain't no surprise there. The pain, guilt, the anger and the rage for what you were forced to do in a wartime situation sticks to your soul. So I knew right then and there that whatever that girl was going through was some kind of war. Because there was hell burning in her eyes. I've been talking to Anna about those men over at Sammy's. They didn't drag her over there. She went with them, willingly.
That don't make any sense. This girl was running for her life. And on the inside of Sammy's, there were three words written on the wall. Covered in blood. Never seen anything like it.
Sammy ever tell you boys stories about the Sanglante?
Sure. Thought he was just trying to scare us.
Sanglante is French for covered in blood. Now, they can be traced back to the original settlers who came here looking for a new life, but instead found only death. It all turned around when they incorporated the new ceremonies into their religious practice.
Like human sacrifice. That part always stuck with me. So you think Anna's one of them?
All I know for certain is that girl is mixed up with a bunch of very bad people.
Lincoln?
I need to show you something. Can you shed any light on this?
Look, Cher, my eyes have been on you for weeks now. I see the shit you put up with around here.
It's not so bad.
What about the way Phil back there can't keep his hands off your ass? Or the way the cheap bastards around here never leave you a tip? That not so bad? This place ain't ever gonna deliver the happiness you deserve. But we can.
Why are you saying such sweet things to me?
Maybe you shouldn't be asking why I'm saying these things to you. But why hasn't someone said them to you sooner? Be part of us, Anna, baby.
body. She made me feel welcome, like I belonged.
Is that why you went to Sim?
Well, they didn't give me a choice. They said it was the only way that I could be purified.
Let me go. I won't say anything. Please.
Well, I tried to stop them, but I couldn't. I just had to get out of there, and he... The crying. And the tears and the blood, he was choking. The sadness.
Look at me, Anna. People like this have a process for indoctrinating folks. Where else did Bonnie take you?
A nightclub. Louis Blanche, that's where they bring people into the family.
Yeah, I know it. A hippie club downtown.
And that playing card? That's the only way they'll let you inside.
Got you. Hey, you did good here, Anna.
You did good. I did good. Careful of the fallen sky. The mind descends, the flesh consumes. The sky falls, the mind descends. The mind descends, the flesh consumes.
This girl needs help. Doctors and nurses looking after her.
You really think that's what'll happen? Girl like her with nothing to her name? I mean, they'll toss her in a padded cell and just forget about her. We both know how much this city cares for the poor and the infirmed.
So we're all she's got.
I'll get her some nourishment. You do what you got to do, son.
Thanks, Father.
Need new wheels in Tickfall.
On it, lad. Just getting her warmed up.
Here's your car, boss.
Appreciate it.